Hello guys, and welcome to JavaFX tutorial for beginners. So in this video we will see how to install scene builder and overview of scene builder, how to use this. So scene builder is a tool that user can design the GUI or user interface for their application or software. So scene builder is main use of this. We can drag and drop the components like button, and we don't need to give the writing the XY code in a file. So for this we can use the scene builder. So firstly download the scene builder. For this open the your browser and type the scene builder and search. Now open the first link, scene builder. You can see here that it's look like this scene builder is. So now you can see here the download the scene builder for Java 9. If you are using the Java 9, it is the latest version of scene builder for the Java 9. It's released on October 17. You can use this for if you have the Java 9. I have the Java 8, so I am here using the Java 8. Here the lot of option like for this Linux, Mac OS. I'm here using the Windows 64-bit, so I'm choosing this option Windows installer 64-bit and download this. Click here. So download, say save the start the download. Click here, start download. So download is completed. Just open the files. So some license, just escape the agreement and click on next. Set up the install scene builder folder. You can browse the file, and also I will browse, and in here scene and okay, and click next. Install the setup. Now you can see here I have already created, so it's so recent .fxml files, or you can click on new project or open the project. You can see here for the desktop basic application, complex application, you can create. I will later show you how to use this. Firstly, we need to add this scene builder in our Eclipse. So scene builder works on .fxml file. You can see here, create the new others, and in JavaFX the new fxml document is available now, so we can create the fxml file. Next, give the name main and finish. Okay, so which we have done here in this .java class, we can using scene builder we can drag and drop, and this will be added in this fxml file. I will show you later. So let's see how to add the scene builder in our Eclipse. Okay, now install the Eclipse. So now install the scene builder in our Eclipse. So go to Window, Preferences, or JavaFX, search JavaFX. Now you can see the scene builder executable file. Browse this where you install the scene builder. Okay, go to those path, select scene in scene builder, and this is the scene builder.exe. Click here, click on open, click apply, apply and close. Okay, so now we can see here, if you right click here,
open with scene builder. So we can open the .fxml file in scene builder.
So let's see what is our overview of scene builder. So there are menu. So file, we can create a new file. This new file, new fxml file, or we can open or save the files. So this is a common in edit, view, content properties, layout. In insert, we can insert the containers, buttons, shapes, 3D. Okay, modify, arrange, preview. You can see the preview of our GUI or user interface which we will design. Help, you can check our updates about scene builder. Okay, so in this panel you can see the containers. Containers means the border pane which have seen here, the pane we have seen in previous video. In pane we have add the button pane. So instead of this creating the or class in Java file, we can drag this pane into our scene builder. So it's not working because anchor pane firstly. So you delete this. There are one anchor pane. So we don't see here the anchor pane because the layout of anchor pane is preferred with user computed size. Okay, so for this, just our first action is when we open the scene builder or open the .fxml file in scene builder, just change the layout of anchor pane. Click on the anchor pane and go to layout and use the width and height. Now you can see at the anchor pane. In anchor pane, we can add the containers also. We can add the anchor pane. In anchor pane, we can add the pane or tab pane. Instead of this, we can delete this or drag this pane this way. So this way is a this is a container. So next is a controls. So there are different types of controls. We have seen the button. In future videos we will see how it is a checkbox, choice box. Okay, so just grab this and drag here button. You can see the button in pane. If you would grab another pane like anchor pane, I want to grab here, and in anchor pane I want to another button, not in pane, I want to in anchor pane. You can drag here or also we can drag on anchor pane like this, but I will drag here anchor pane. In anchor pane you can see here in pane we have one button, one anchor pane, and in anchor pane we have another button. When we close this, you can see here in anchor pane we have button. So this way we can drag and drop. This is the controls. Next is a glue on. Basically this is used for the mobile application development. This is not for our desktop controls. This is a mobile application controls. Now we can check here the menus, check menu, all the stuff, and group also, tooltip. You can add the tooltip, or we know what is the tooltip. Shapes, there are different types of shapes, circles, you can drag here circles. And charts, bar chart, line chart, okay. And also last in 3D. So this panel is have controls, containers, menus, okay. So in right side, when we choose or when we want to give the name or change the name of button or set the XY site width height or change the color of text, background color, add the image. So this all action we can perform from this panel. So I want to perform the action on button. So in button, the first is a property. In property, we can change the text. We can change the text. Like I want to say hello JavaFX. You can see the text is changed. We can also change the font. So there are three types. Family means we can choose the font which you want. Okay, choose your font. And style, in style italic, you want italic. We'll choose another font. So you can see there are three types: bold, italic, regular, or size of text. We can say size of font 18, or you can also have the slider. You can change the size of text, not the size of button, because we have changed the size of text, so it's change that size of button also. Or we have the text alignment. We can align in the text, or we can also underline the text. Check mark. So now content display. This is for when we add the image button. Which element you want to add on our text? Okay, after alignment, same like this, alignment of text. Effect, you want to add the effect. You can add the effect on button, like lightning, inner shadow, glow. Okay, this way we can add the effect. So all we know, we can add the CSS on JavaFX. So you want to add or apply the small line of CSS on button. You can see here the -fx-background-color. This can change the background color. I will show you. Background color, give the hash code 333, or I will add another text fill. Okay, so this way we can apply the CSS on our components. And rather than if you have the .css file, you can add from here, add the style sheet, and click on add button. It will open the file manager, and you can choose the .css file. This way. Now come to the ID. This is for the .css. I will show you later how to use this. Then go to the layout section. So layout section, we are already familiar with the width and height. I give here the 200 and 200. Okay, but the text cannot see because the font of text we have given here, the 42. So we can also change the height and width like this according to our need. In layout, we can also give the padding for the components. In layout also, we can drag and drop here and there, but if you want to give the your paper heights, like I want to give the 30, it will automatically apply on components. If you want to rotate the components like this, you can rotate. I will give the 0, so it's come to the initial state. So this is a basic of a scene builder. Our last section is the code. This is the most important section, code. Here, so all we know what is the variable. So we have given the, we are creating the variables like integer, string, or we have given the name of variables like int, roll number. So this way we can give here the FX ID for the component. Using the FX ID, we can use this FX ID. Using this FX ID, we can change the color or change the height and width or XY using the Java code. In some situation, we have to, when we click the one button and image, we have to move to the one location to another. So this way we can give the ID and access using FX ID, we can access those component or image using FX ID. So I'm giving here the FX ID like button, and we can use this FX ID and change the color and text and add the action. So this way we can give the FX ID. So next is on action. So we have already seen how to add the event on button, but without FXML we have done this code. So in next video we will see how to add the event using scene builder, but I will tell you the small things. The on action we have used for this to add the event on components. I will show you in later videos. There are a lot of events. Just give the name of method and we can perform the action. And last thing means when we are using the scene builder, we have to create one class. The class name is a controller. When we use the scene builder or .fxml file, firstly we have to create the main.java file. In main.java file we have to give the .fxml file path, and in fxml file we have to create another class which have all the code of like event or all this. And in fxml file we have to give the path of those class. So this class called as a controller class. Okay, so in detail we will see in next video. So you can see here which changes we have done in scene builder. They will automatically added in fxml file, so we don't need to write the code like html or xml file. So this is the scene builder is more helpful to use in our for creating the application or creating the GUI in less time. So this way we can use the scene builder, and also we can preview this. If you want to preview your GUI or user interface, you can control P, or we can rather you can go to the preview and select the show preview. So this way we can use the scene builder. In next video we will see how to add the action event using the scene builder. So see you in next video, guys.